Hi everybody, this is Sean. I wanted to try something a little bit different today. Today I wanted to try linears versus Mac art. I have a drawing tablet, of course, an LCD Wacom, which is nice. I do illustrations and renderings for concept as well, so I have this drawing tool. You don't need this. It's going to be used for my demonstration, but what I want to talk about is the difference between doing a linear of something. So I want to create a layout and I figure out what I like and draw it out first, versus doing something like, for example, here's InDesign, and I have a tool that I can create a box and I can fill it with, fill it with black and so on. When do you do what? And when does it make sense to do a rendering? When does it make sense to do something like this in InDesign where you have the existing layout tools? Or do you just, go directly to this Photoshop format? Well, in my case, Photoshop. This could be a marker pad, it could be a sketchbook, it could be Photoshop, it could be whatever you want it to be. But essentially, the idea is, when do you do this? I'll start with the idea of InDesign. And InDesign, or any layout program, essentially, I have a fundamental problem with creating ideas. If you already have an idea, you already have something that you know you have to do, an existing photograph or existing copy, a brand, a logo, all those things that already exist, and you just have to put something together because you have, six paragraphs of copy, you have an image, a headline, and some kind of a coupon on the bottom. Okay. You can go ahead and do that, of course. But immediately, as soon as I draw this box, I use the box as the example again. As soon as I draw the box, I'm limited to a couple of things. I can create the box, I can scale the box, I can change the color of the box, I can do all those things. Now I can draw a, like an elliptical shape over top of that and fill it with something different. So I can do those things. But the problem that I have with this is that now I'm working with this oval shape that I'm giving, and sure I can resize it, but this is not ideas. Ideas and design are slightly different. And I know that's an obvious thing to say, but I want to kind of explain more about why it's different. As I look through InDesign here, if I click on this tool here, I have my type tool, which has a couple of options. I can do a couple of things with that. My pointer tool can select things. The circle tool and the shape tool in general, I can do a polygon, I can do a square. I don't know if you understand where I'm going with this, but essentially these are all fixed things. They already exist. Here's a series of colors I can use. So what I'm doing in InDesign or in a layout program is I'm making choices based on the tools in front of me. However, if I go to back to my Photoshop page, let's say, for example, in the case of a layout, I'm going to draw this quick square shape. So I have this, but now I don't have any tools. I'm kind of looking at this saying, okay, I have something to work with here. So I think I have a headline, which is going to go, my first thought is, ooh, what if the headline was really big? So here's my cool headline. So I haven't chosen a font. I'm not encumbered by, is this Helvetica or is this Times Roman or is it something else? All I know is I have a big space and I have a huge headline. And I'm going to draw this sort of dude down here. And I want to also do this quick demonstration to show people who are sort of a bit worried that they can't draw, that, oh no, I wouldn't do linears because I can't draw. Well, okay, that's a guy. You know that's a guy. It's obvious that it's a guy. So he's got, maybe there's some copy that describes what he's doing. He's a happy insurance customer. So big smile, and maybe he has, his car in the background here. I'm just obviously just doing this really crazy quick sketch to make a point that I don't have to be able to draw a car for me to know that this is a car. So his car has been fixed. It's now beautiful. He's super happy. Maybe he's even saying something. Now, in about 30 seconds, I've been able to kind of create this idea. But why would I care about that? Well, I care because what if that's not my only idea? So I've decided, hey, there's a couple ways, pardon my bad drawing there. I've decided that there's a couple of ways to handle this. One way is that way. Another way, huge happy guy. So here he is, and he's super happy. Now, sorry, I was missing my shift key there, but you get the idea. My cool headline is now it's there, and his car is going to be, let's say it's roughly here. I mean, look how bad. And I'm an illustrator. I can actually draw. Like I know how to do this. And look, all I'm doing is this, right? Because I know from this that I have this idea. And so this little bit of copy down here, it still belongs there. So I've decided that there it is. But now maybe I want to put something in the background. And so I can kind of fiddle with these things a bit. All I've done is sketch out these little thumbnails. And I'm already giving myself some ideas. So maybe my idea now, I would go to my next page of sketches. And maybe the whole thing is this, just this huge kind of detail of the car. So now it's not even the whole car. It's just a huge detail of something because maybe his bumper was fixed, right? And we want to just highlight the bumper. But that's a car. That's all you need to indicate a car. And maybe I'm not even going to have my happy guy in there. I'm just going to put the headline down below. My cool headline. So I might decide later, you know what, I actually need the guy. I realize now that it just wasn't interesting without him. I don't really get that it's him that's happy. I'm wondering why I look at this car, so I've decided that I need him. So now, instead, maybe this is actually a word balloon, and I can just decide that really quickly. So the headline is coming from the guy. And see, I've spent less than a couple of minutes, and I've got three ideas down in front of me. Now, what is the value of these ideas? The value is that essentially these things can communicate your concept really quickly. So my InDesign page, if I want to, now I've got to create the type. So my cool headline, whatever that was going to be, I've got to decide the size of it. But right now, the only mode that I'm in, the only thing that I have in front of me is what that font is and how big it is. If you understand what I'm getting at, I don't have any control over here about how liquid my thinking can be. Because what if suddenly I want this photo, this to be really huge? Well, okay, I mean, that's easy enough to do. I can click away and I can make this big. But what's happening here is I look at this and I go, yeah, I don't like the font, so, I don't know. Okay, well, I just killed an idea that could have been really cool because I was nowhere near ready to decide the typeface. But seeing that typeface influenced my decision already. Now, I could have changed the typeface. I'm not arguing that this is any different than a graphic design process, but I'm not ready for that process yet. Right now, I'm still trying to decide, is this ad about the guy? Is it about the car? Or is it about the headline? Because another way I might handle this is I might decide it's all about the headline. The guy is down here. He's pretty small, but he's still pretty happy. His car is kind of in the background. So, there it is. The little bits of copy, really sort of narrow copy treatment way at the bottom. And my, oops, pardon my menu there. My cool headline goes there. So if you look at these two side by side, you can see that I'm already establishing design style. Now, I don't know what that photo is going to look like yet. I don't have the photo of the guy yet. I don't have the photo of the car. So this frees my thinking. I can make some decisions about what that car looks like. So in another scenario, I might decide maybe it's the profile of the car. So I haven't even decided yet. And again, look how bad the drawing is here. And I can draw. I know how to draw. And this is all I'm doing. I'm not even spending time thinking about how inaccurate this car drawing is, because I know that this is a car. And I could decide maybe my headline isn't big or small, maybe it's kind of in the middle somewhere. And maybe what I want to do is some really cool kind of Swiss type, just sort of running down the center. And then that just makes me think, what if the dude is just right underneath that in some kind of cool symmetric layout? So now he's the happy guy, and maybe he's saying this bit of type, but I don't want to put it into a word balloon. I don't really feel like that's the right thing. So I can decide now, you know what? I don't want a three-quarter view of the car. Maybe a profile of the car would be cool, but I'm not working with one photo that's limiting my thinking. I can look at this page of linears and make any decision that I want. And this goes for logos as well. If you have, my company, whatever that might be, let's call it Cool Stuff. Let's say that's what our company was called. And you have to do a logo for it. And you're not really sure where to begin. Well, the good news is that you can just sort of make some notes here. And this is what another thing I like to do in my linear stage, if this sort of helps you, is I'll make some little notes here that'll remind me of things as I go. So I might start my whole process by saying it's cool, because that's the client brief. It's technology. It's young. Maybe their target market is 18 to 30-year-olds. So cool, tech, young, and fun. So let's say it's those things. And cool stuff is a device, or it's a bunch of devices, and we have to design a logo. Well, the linear process still works. And in fact, this is a great way to start thinking about your logos. Things that you would think you'd want to just jump right into Illustrator or InDesign and start working with, but not necessarily. Just sit down and open your mind. Let go of the idea of, I have a visual. How do I use that visual in my layout? Start thinking about what that visual could or could not be, because maybe it's nothing. So you could start out with something like, let's just say, I wanted to do something that was so cool is kind of in these square letters. I don't know what this font is yet, but I'm doing this because I'm thinking to myself, if it's technology, maybe it's, maybe there's some kind of LED sort of font. I'm not saying that this is necessarily a good design choice. I'm just sort of trying to give you an example of how to start free thinking. So I kind of look at that and I go, oh, what if it's that LCD type, or maybe it's, the type is big pixels and, maybe that's interesting. Or I can decide that if it's a device, maybe I, sorry, my bad straight line there. So if I have, let's say something like, I don't know, this represents maybe a device window. I don't even know yet. And as I'm linearing, the good thing is I don't have to know. I can just fool around. So maybe there's some kind of a home button there. So maybe this is almost like, a device. Is it a little bit 3D, maybe? And maybe cool stuff. is in the window of some device, and maybe that's interesting. But you can see how I can just start to play around with things. I'm not influenced by fonts yet. So I can even decide, oh, what if it's just something much more sort of random like this? And maybe there's maybe this is enclosed inside of some kind of a button shape or something like that. And maybe there's some kind of a graphic on top of that that I could start playing around with. The idea is that I can just create pages of these and just jam away at the stuff and try to free my thinking. And so I'm a big fan of doing linears. And I just wanted to do this short video for you to sort of show you that you don't need to know how to draw. Don't worry about being able to draw. Just think about what you can do with a free, open, white page. No tools. There's no type tool. There's no square drawing tool. There's just you, your brain, and the subject matter. And I think that that is a really great discipline to build. If you're new, you're just going to school and they're not teaching you this, everything is in Photoshop or InDesign or Illustrator, or you sit down and you start writing code for a website, you know what? That's all great. But even a website, I can even sit here and I can draw something that looks like a big browser window. So here's my browser window. So maybe my navigation is way at the top like this. And maybe my footer is, I've decided now, I just want to see what it would look like if the border of my web page was a torn piece of paper. And then it revealed this little footer underneath. But I've got all of my home button here, buy, join, etc. I can just kind of roughly figure out, I can see that that's navigation. I know it's navigation. My navigation's at the top. Maybe it's not this kind of a shaped bar. Maybe there's no bar here. And I can make this decision as I go. I can just kind of look at it and go, yeah, you know what? I think that free navigation is better. Oh, but maybe each one of these navigations is some kind of a goofy tab or something. Maybe it's like there's a shape behind it. And I can start to play around with this. And maybe my hero image, I don't even know what the image is yet. But maybe it's people smiling because they're happy, and this is a website about an awesome company to work for. Everybody looks like they're really happy. You know, I might decide that that's my header image, and that I'm going to have a sidebar of extra information over here, and maybe that sidebar has something else. So you can see that, again, without doing a lot of Photoshop work yet, I can start to think about, well, what might this look like? Do I want big navigation, small navigation? So if you have a project where you don't have the elements in hand, you get to decide. You get to think of these things. Don't just jump right into a design application where you're limited to a photo and how big it is, type and what font it is, and what shapes you can create. Because if you do that, everything will have a photo with a square box and Helvetica type and whatever. And those things can look great. And if you already know what you need to do, then that's a really good way to proceed. You just get down and dirty with the elements. But if you don't know and you have the opportunity to figure it out, this is a very cool way. And I would really encourage you to start doing this just as a fun experiment. If you have no real work to do, or if you're in school and they're not teaching this, was what I was trying to explain before, just do it anyway. Do it anyway. Give it a try. Just fool around. Don't worry about whether you can draw. I'm an artist. I can draw, and look what I did. I don't worry about the drawing, because this is not about drawing. This is about design. It's about free thinking, opening your mind to choosing new ways to see things so that you're not limited by a layout you've already seen, a color that you haven't chosen yet, a font you don't like yet, a box or a square or a circle you're not happy with. This way you just get to think, oh, torn paper, big heads, goofy navigation, I don't know, and a big thing on the side. That's literally your thought process. And I think it's a really awesome way to create good ideas, because good ideas make good design. If your idea is solid and you have a good design to deliver it, there's nothing more powerful. a great design without a good idea behind it looks pretty, but there isn't a lot of substance to it. There's a great balance you can strike, and I think this is a fantastic way. Just wanted to give you this little bit of inspiration, or at least a thought about how you might want to look at your creative projects. Don't think just because you're doing a website and it's digital that you can't get out a piece of paper and start drawing. There's nothing wrong with it. And in fact, there's no other way to duplicate this process. You can't go into InDesign and duplicate this process. This is free form thinking. You might hate it. It might work against your instincts. You may be more of an execution designer than a conceptual thinker, but you never know until you try. And conceptual thinking is really, really important. No matter what you do, a good idea, you've got to have a good idea behind it. And maybe that idea is already there, and that's great. But if it's not, this is a fantastic way to get there. And pop me your comments. Let me know if you like this style of video. It's something that I just thought of trying at the last minute and figured I'd put it up. Let me know if you understand, you don't understand, you agree, don't agree, you want to try some drawings and need some advice. Let me know. And anybody else who has some advice to offer on this topic, please pop it in the comments and let's discuss it. But yeah, linears. I'm a big fan. It's not old school. It is conceptual thinking. There's a difference. It's okay to do this. And I hope you will too. Take care now.